the price of oil is low, they buy it from foreign countries. You understand? To stop the bleeding of capital. They pay lower prices when it's someone else, when labor can't benefit from the higher price. You understand that? Now that it's so much, like over $100 a barrel, they buy it in their own country. Until they say, okay, we'll give it to you for like $50 a barrel. Then they'll go back to Iraq and buy it.
So what does all this have to do with you? I mean, I love you're talking about all this. You have a lot of knowledge. Where did you learn all this about history?
No, I want you to get right to your point.
No, but I mean, you're very smart. You know all about history.
What I'm saying is relevant to what these people are going through.
Yeah, I mean, like, you still got to get up every day and get a job. And
No.
Hold on. Now it's my time.
How do you approach your problem?
It's my time. In the slavery, what was your chance in the slave system? Nothing. Today, what's your chance if you're an unfortunate young guy like this?
Nothing.
You do. She's right on that point. But it takes a focused burst of energy from within yourself to conceive of what you might do in a situation.
How many people have made it from nothing?
I don't want to get back into that because they might have other advantages that we don't know or that are not documented or they may not be revealing.
Are you saying that you have more chance today as a young kid like this unfortunate kid?
You can, than slavery. I don't even want to go back and forth on slavery because I think the Jim Crow period presented advantages and disadvantages, but today those advantages don't necessarily exist, even as in the Jim Crow days. Was just separating the white and the black cultures or ethnic community or economic realities. Okay, but today you actually have a deal more access to markets, but you got to be creative. How many people who don't have a place to stay can actually take the time out to cogitate and think of some idea? They're not even on that page. You got to be my age.
I understand that, but how did they?
You gotta be my
age.
You're
saying all these young kids came from no money or bad family situations?
No, but listen to what I'm saying.
I don't get where.
What I'm saying to you is that they're in a youthful stage of life.
And they don't realize that they're wasting years just hanging out here. And
yeah, they may not. Even when I was.
And when they go try to straighten out their life, they're gonna be like 28 years old.
28? They're 20. 28 is still young in my book. I see 28 year olds.
But the point is, then. You just can't hang out. Nothing. It's boring.
Well, that's what you know that.
I think
you
this
know
is
that.
Boring.
You know that.
I don't know how these people can sit here all night and just sit there and talk all
why
night.
Don't you speak?
Oh, that's
why don't you speak with them? With them. I live stream. Ask this guy, for example.
That's creative. That's good. That's good that they can communicate. If they sit out here all night, they got nothing else to do. If they
do this day after day after year.
And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. Because 28, but no, there's nothing that they can do. They don't have that. They don't have that level of knowledge to be able to get any phone access whatsoever.
What it amounts to is we're not all born with the same amount of intelligence.
I'm not that's Freudian. That's Darwin and Freud.
But the point is that who runs the people that run companies are smart people.
The people that run companies are trying to get people like this to drop bombs on Al-Qaeda. Okay? So they got something to contribute. And they got a lot
to
contribute.
So they want them for what? Oh, like to go fight in a war.
No, what I'm saying to you is that these people actually put up a big tent over here. See that GameStop over there? GameStop, they're a national retail chain.
Yeah.
Okay? Some of the top computer manufacturers with all the cerebral prowess. To show all these big army men in these big gigantor suits with these big guns and shit. And they actually had a competition for the fastest video game player. It turned into a national competition.
Oh,
and
is that when they had that over here in the university place?
They may have had one. I think they did have one down there, but they had one right in the middle up here on the promenade. And yes, they took the players from these things from each cities and sponsored a major event. The guy that's dropping bombs on Al-Qaeda, making like $800,000 a year, is the winner of that contest. He's sitting there in a trailer somewhere playing video games, and it's actually drones. He's dropping bombs on fucking Al-Qaeda. That's what that is. So they understand the value of this. okay, like the skateboard riders. You see the skateboard riders, the bicycles. See the skateboard riders, the bicyclists? Don't look because they're all over the park. If you haven't seen them yet, you ain't gonna see them in 5 seconds. But they're all over the park. Skateboarders, bicycle riders, rollerblade artists, musical instruments. You got, you know what I mean? You know skateboarders are over there, the bicycle. I'm saying all of this.
It's people from all mixes around.
That's what I'm saying. This is a youthful energy.
Are you going home now?
Me? No, I don't have a home.
No, that's what we were talking about.
Yeah. I came up here on a botched road trip. I came up here with 12 of my buddies, and what had happened was I figured out they're on heroin, and I ditched that crowd because I don't mess around with opiates. I come from Key West, Florida.
So how long have you been?
2 weeks.
Mark. Do you like it?
I love it.
It's a little scary because I'm used.
I'm lost.
So you're just
gonna
hang out here all summer?
No. Well, I just got a job, so I might be here for the summer, but I'm not doing winter here.
What kind of job?
I'm gonna be selling art at an art gallery.
Oh, good.
I'm an Army veteran. I've been to war 3 times, so I've pretty much put in.
This man right here.
No, I'm broke. It's shit. About to go get food stamps and shit again, but the VA will help me whatever city I go to.
Oh, good.
But actually, New York. I got a sign. I have never had to sit down and beg for money in my life. But I just told my ACL 4 days ago, and I can't walk, work, hustle, do anything. So
where did you tear it at?
Boston.
And then where'd you go to the hospital? Boston.
Yeah, and then I went to the VA here. It hurts. I got shot in Fallujah, and didn't hurt as bad as this. It was by far the most painful injury I've ever had. But anyhow, back to where I was going. New York, they really do. I have not had a problem eating here since I've been here. And I've had people throw me money, which I'm an honest guy. I've been losing money for the right stuff, so it's been nice. But my name's Mark, anyhow.
Well,
if you see me around, where you guys from?
Well, he's filming. He does the Occupy. He has a live stream. And he's live streaming.
Oh, I'm from the Occupy?
Yeah.
I got mad friends from Occupy Boston. Have you been up there yet?
Boston? No. Well, I was in Boston, but before Occupy.
Now how do you be an Occupy member? Like the cops keep telling me you guys hate me. The cops keep telling me you guys hate veterans.
We have veterans for peace occupiers.
I know that. I've seen them on Boston.
Why would they hate veterans?
I don't know. I don't know.
Ask the veterans for peace. They are always there.
But I never did they get veterans. So were you in the Army?
Yeah, I was an Army infantryman. I'm sorry to bother you guys.
No, you're not. No, he was talking.
Hey,
he was interviewing him.
Of course.
Nice to meet you.
We'll be back. I have to call him because I have 2 pets I have to take care of, and I'm hungry.
I'll be alright, thanks.
Alright. You guys want a beer?
No, I don't.
No, I'm fine.
Thank you. No, but we'll see you again. He's here every day live streaming. Are you going to be here tomorrow?
Yeah, I might go to the VA in a little while.
Okay. No, I just have been out since I could get home.
They already fed over there. Is there anywhere I can go get some food from the Occupy people?
If they are there, they should be over there. Check it out.
Anyway, I gotta get home.
But okay. The issue is that yes, there is some reality to what you're talking about. To in other words, there's an energy here that even these cerebral guys,
all I know is
they understand that
every
when
day
they
and I say I just. I couldn't do this all the time. It drives me crazy. I just couldn't sit here and just hang out all the time.
But that doesn't say anything. That only says, that's like saying
I mean, everybody does.
I'm going to tell you what that's like saying. I can't understand how my girlfriend allows me to penetrate her.
Well, no, I don't want to go.
No, I'm saying because I'm a man. You know what I mean? In other words, you're saying you can't understand it.
No.
But I'm saying that's just like they might say that they can't understand you.
I just gotta believe that most people, if they
just because
the
I'm saying that just because you can't
have a nice house and go home and sleep in a nice bed, and I wouldn't want to have to sleep on the street.
That
know.
May be true, but how do you get a nice place in an environment like this?
Oh, now you have me on. I don't want to be on. All I know is I moved to New York.
How would you tell Mark or the other
and
guy?
And I worked and I kept my apartment and I paid
wait
my rent every month.
You're not,
and that's
you're
it.
Only on you. I'm asking you something else.
I don't want to be on camera.
Well, then you complaining my viewers are wrong.
Am I wrong?
Did you see Mark? Did you remember just talking to Mark?
Yeah.
How would you say to Mark, here's how you can get a comfortable place to live?
Let me tell you something. I would think probably some of these people come back from the service have some problems with post-traumatic stress syndrome. Some of them are
ask you that.
Because, you know, I'm just saying.
I did not ask you that.
I would do everything I could.
What would you tell Mark?
I would not want to be here.
Wait a minute.
I would not.
What would you tell Mark? How would you convince Mark or the other guy that the instrument? How would you say,
I don't know.
Would you like to have a comfortable place to sleep?
How do you tell somebody that does,
I'm asking you a question.
How do you tell them not to do
I'm
drugs?
I'm just asking
they
you a question. I'm just
know.
Asking you a question. How would you get
I
Mark?
I would go wherever I had to go and talk to anybody that would help me to get out of my situation.
What you're saying doesn't sound very rational.
I would do anything I could to not end up, and that's why I got to get up every day and be disciplined and, you just can't hang out.
I don't know if communicating with you like this is going to change
anything. Am I making any sense?
Is she making any sense?
You're only making sense to yourself. You're not allowing other people to
Is she making any sense?
You have allowed other people.
I don't understand.
You're not making sense out of what other people are saying.
I stopped the poll. You are making sense
to herself.
89% you are not making sense.
I don't get it.
What I'm saying to you is that you're only making sense to yourself.
90% you are not making sense. I just started it. You can ask them.
Now, what is the question you asked?
Talk to them if you want.
What would you suggest to Mark to get in a comfortable place, like you said, comfy?
Yeah, he deserves it.
I don't know his. Some people you could give
him something,
still end up back here.
That's the wrong answer.
I don't know his mind.
That's the
I
wrong
don't know
answer.
Him.
Well, he's a regular veteran. He deserves it.
That's
tell
the
him.
Wrong answer.
You didn't hear what I said.
I heard what you said, and what you said is the wrong answer.
Some of them.
What you're saying is the wrong answer.
Some people you could help them, and they still screw up.
I didn't ask you that. That's not even related to the question.
I don't know.
I said, what would you say to Mark?
I don't know him. I don't know what kind of person he is.
That doesn't make us any.
No, because some people you help them, and they screw up.
No, I didn't say you could.
I don't know him.
I didn't say that. I said, what would you do if you could? If you. How would
I
you begin? How would you begin to help Mark if you had to try? If you set out to help Mark, what would you do?
Give him a job?
No, I think I don't know his mind.
Here we go again.
Some people
just ain't going there.
You don't understand.
Okay, so you don't understand why people are here. I see.
What
okay.
I'm saying is, you
no,
can,
I don't. They need
take,
to know what you
they
need.
Take
what you're
people
saying.
That are homeless. They can give them an apartment. And they can give them everything.
Who can do all this?
Say you take them and say, here's a place you can live in.
Who? Suppose
anybody.
Does
somebody has money. Like they that. Own an apartment building.
When did you ever
and
hear
they
about
go
that
in
being
there,
said? Wait a minute. Wait.
I don't know. Some people
wait.
Just screw everything
You're
up.
You're off again. You're off.
You don't agree with me. I don't agree.
Are you saying you hope that if you tried to help Mark get into an apartment that he would fuck it up and be right back out here?
I don't know him.
Oh, what do you do with the
are
mentally
you
ill?
He's mentally ill?
No, I don't mean.
Are you saying that
no,
he's
you're
mentally
not listening
ill?
To me. Some people.
Yeah, he's here.
I'm not
he
saying,
must be mentally
I'm not
ill.
Saying some people.
No, let me say. Okay.
I'm trying to address this specifically to Mark. You just spoke with Mark.
Some people are self-destructive.
You just spoke to Mark.
Listening.
Did you,
I don't
did
know
you,
him.
By speaking to Mark,
I don't
did you,
know him.
By speaking to Mark, did you think he was self-destructive?
I don't know.
No, he's very kind. He's very kind.
Did you ever date a girl?
No.
Okay. Did you ever meet somebody? You start going out with them,
I didn't,
and you think they're really
past.
Nice, and then 5 months down the road, they turn it into a nightmare. You don't know people when you first meet them. I don't know
you're
you.
Way past
you
or anything. Me. I'm not asking you anything of
I
that
can't
nature.
Say. I don't know.
I'm not asking you anything of that nature. I'm just
I
saying.
I'm telling you, there are people you could give them everything and they screw it all off. I don't know.
Yeah,
there
but what
people,
does this have to do with Mark?
It has to do
you
with.
Just